Story of the day, the state GOP and DFL conventions happening right now.
We start with Chief Political Reporter Tom Hauser, who is live in Rochester with the latest Republican endorsements. Tom.
And Tom, we're in for another crazy day and perhaps night here in Rochester. We essentially have a three-way tie for the lead for the Republican endorsement for governor after one ballot. However, the second ballot has just been brought up to the stage. We do not have those results just yet. But the next ballot will give us a better idea of just how long of a night this might be. Let's take a look at the numbers. From the first ballot, you will see Jeff Johnson in the lead at 32%, followed by Dave Thompson at 30 and Marty Seifert at 29%, essentially a three-way tie. Rob Farnsworth came in a distant fourth at 8%. Now, earlier in the afternoon, all of the candidates had a chance to play videos and give speeches and do their demonstrations here on the convention floor to do a little bit of campaigning. And then in each of their speeches, they, of course, made it a point to go after Mark Dayton fast and furious.
4 years ago, a liberal huckster named Mark Dayton rolled into the town square of Minnesota with his square-wheeled wagon and tried to sell the people of Minnesota an elixir of big government and higher taxes. And we are here to give people the real cure.
He expresses outrage at the provisions that are in bills he just signed the week before. As Rob mentions, he tells parents of sick kids to go buy pot on the streets for them. He is a true believer that government ought to control our lives. He is from the nanny state wing of the DFL party that wants to make us all wear helmets in the bathtub.
4 years ago, we lost a close governor's race. Last time, we didn't all unite and come together. Ah, but this time it's going to be different.
And again, you can tell all those Republican candidates just chomping at the bit to be able to take on Mark Dayton, but we don't know which one is going to emerge just yet. However, right now, we are getting the numbers for the second ballot. Rob Farnsworth, we're being told, has 1.9%, so he is going to be dropped off the ballot. Let's just hold on. Johnson has gone up to 38%. Let's stick with this for a moment.
Seifert
stays at about 29, rounded up to 30%.
29.7%.
And 29.7% for Dave Thompson. So again, a little separation for Jeff Johnson. He's a little further in the lead, but still a very tight three-way race with one of the candidates, Rob Farnsworth, by rule having to drop out because he had less than 5% of the vote. Again, this is breaking news. This is the second ballot. 60% is needed for endorsement, so now they will have to go on and do a third ballot, and who knows how many more. Now, speaking of long endorsement ballots, let's take a look at what happened a little bit earlier today in the U.S. Senate endorsement battle. We had a crazy day here. It went until 2 o'clock in the morning. They could not choose a U.S. Senate candidate to endorse, so they had to resume the battle today. It took almost 24 hours. It came down between Mike McFadden and Chris Dahlberg, and on the 10th ballot, Mike McFadden was finally declared the winner.
I look forward to taking the fight to Al Franken. Yeah. We have a better vision, all of us in this room. We need to get back onto the road to growth and prosperity. We can do better. We know we can do better. And together, all of us in this room as a team, we'll fight and we will win. In November, we will beat Al Franken.
And there you heard Mike McFadden, very hoarse from that late night endorsement battle that resumed today, and Rob Farnsworth right now dropping out of the governor's endorsement race. We'll have a full update on everything going on here tonight at 10 o'clock. Live in Rochester, Tom Hauser, 5 Eyewitness News.
Tom, thanks. Two Republican candidates for governor opted to go straight to a primary in August, and one of them announced his lieutenant governor running mate this morning outside the convention hall. Businessman Scott Honor chose State Senator Karen Housley. Housley is serving her first term in the Minnesota Senate and also works in real estate.
In addition to being a successful businesswoman, she's a wife, a mom, and actively involved in her community. And I'm pretty sure she's a hockey fan. Karen, I'm excited about traveling the state to share our vision and passion for Minnesota.
He has a plan that will keep jobs in Minnesota and grow jobs in Minnesota. Scott Honor has a plan that will educate the kids in Minnesota, the best in the country. And Scott Honor's health care plan, we can keep our doctor.
Well, the Housley name is well known here in Minnesota. Her husband, Phil Housley, is a Hall of Fame hockey player and coached in the NHL last season. The other GOP candidate going straight to the primary is Kurt Zellers, a former Speaker of the House. He did show up at the convention, but did not enter his name for the endorsement.